Hello everyone, this is Maureen and welcome to My Crochet Story, where I share with you two things that I love, teaching and crochet. Well, today is AMIGURUMI Wednesday and I'm here to show you the progress on the three AMIGURUMIs that I'm working on at the moment. Now, none of these are for AMIGURUMI Wars because I am finished with that for the month of May. And until Anita from YOH Crochets lets us know who the designer is that she's chosen for June, I get to work on some of my other little AMIGURUMI projects. But before I show you those, let me say thank you so much for being here. I hope you enjoy seeing my progress with the AMIGURUMIs that I choose to make. I have told several in the past that it wasn't something that I thought that I would really take a liking to doing, but I have found a new love, and that's AMIGURUMIs. So, and that doesn't mean that I've quit doing other projects. I mean, another new project, as you well know, I'm working on a mosaic, which is a blanket, and Sophie, which is another blanket, and Maureen is not into blankets, but anyway, I digress, and I'm so sorry, I was chasing a squirrel there for a moment, but I just wanted to say thank you so much for always looking at my content when I upload it. I really do appreciate your support. If this is your first time here in my channel, please take a look around at the other content, you know, that I've uploaded. And if you see something that you like, please consider hitting that subscribe button and then look for the bell, which I like to say has little hugs on the side. And be sure and hit it so that every time I upload content, you're notified. So, AMIGURUMI Wednesday. Let me show you what I worked on this past week. Now, As I said, I have three projects going. Most of the time, folks tell you if you're going to do AMIGURUMI, work on only one at a time. But, you know, Maureen likes to go big or go home. So, just let me get right into it and show you what I'm working on. All right. So, last week, I told you I was picking up a Gnome pattern. Now, this is called Blossom. She represents spring and summer. So what I have got finished on her so far is just her little body and the little gold shirt that she's wearing and a little bit of her, I guess you could say, face, head that you're going to see up here at the top. Now, that's all I've got finished on her so far because I kind of ran into a little bit of a I don't know what I want to do. Now, it shows here for you to take yarn, pull it through, and then separate out the strands, which, other than the fact it's going to take a long time to do that, I mean, and I don't have a problem with it, that's okay. But last October, you'll see in one of my videos, I made Suki for Halloween, and I really liked the braiding that we did here on the hair. So I haven't made up my mind yet if I'm just going to put the yarn in and then braid her hair or if I'm going to leave it loose like it is here in the pattern. So I got stuck there for just a little bit. I could have gone ahead and done her arms and made her little hat, gone ahead and attached her nose, but like I said, since I'm working on three at one time, I just decided to stop and, you know, take a minute. So if you want to help me decide, leave a comment down there and in the comment section and tell me what you think. Do you think I ought to go with her little fluffed out pigtails or do you think I ought to give her braids? Which one? So anyway, that's where I'm at with her. Let's see. Let's talk about Mr. Panda here. Boho the Panda. Now for a while, remember, I only had his head going. And again, on him, just like on my little blossom there, all I worked on was the body. But folks, that's a lot of body there going on, let me tell you. Now, let's see. Yeah, I made a little bit of a boo-boo here. I meant for this to be in the back, but you know what? I got to looking at where the front legs and the back legs are going to go, so I decided, well, you know what? That's going to, let's see, which hand? There we go. That'll get covered up with the placement of the front legs, which is what I will be working on him this next week, because remember I told you that each one of these legs, the front legs and the hind legs, have different parts to them. So not only do you make the leg, but you also do each one of these little gray puffs here that go on the toes, and then the little pad there for the bottom of the foot. So there's going to be quite a bit entailed with doing the hind legs and the back legs. And then there's also just a little bitty button tail that goes on the back, which won't take, you know, not even 5 minutes to do up. So that's what I'll be working on with him. Now, you know, I really wasn't thinking all that much, but what have I got here? Oh, I forgot to cut out that little bitty piece. It's when I went back in and highlighted the eyes. It didn't ask for it to be highlighted, but I just wanted those little eyes there to show off a little bit better, so I went in and did a little highlighting there with the white thread. I didn't expect his body to be this big, tell you the truth, but I guess, you know, big head needs a big body, especially with him sitting down. I just really didn't expect it to be this big, but that's okay. As you can tell, I'm still working on how I want to make this transition here, so it's not so definite, but I'm still working on a few ideas of different videos I've been looking at on how to make that transition not so noticeable. But like I said, that little stick out there, get covered up with those legs. All right, and then the last thing I'm working on is this this next zodiac, the Geminis. And this is what they're supposed to look like when I get finished with them. Alright, so let me show you how far I've gotten so far. So, here we are. Now, this one I just finished the head on this morning. And this one here will get its head later this evening. Now, in the other Zodiac dolls I've made in the past from this book, it seems to have a really, really tall forehead. And in fact, I stopped right here before we started doing the decrease here for the crown and to get it up to the top. I was supposed to put on 4 more additional rows. And I decided, this is mine, so I decided, I cut out those extra 4 rows because I wanted it to look a little more natural. It may come back to bite me in the butt later whenever I get ready to make the hair pieces to put on there. But the only thing I can think of is that it's just going to make the hair piece come down a little bit further, you know, on the neckline. And but we'll have to wait and see. I may have to do a little bit of adjustment there on the hair cap since I didn't make the forehead so tall. But again, you know, like I said, I think I really liked how did the little collar. We'll be coming back in, let's see, where is that stitch? Oh, it's right there where we put on the little skirt. I was thinking that I might make one of these a girl and the other one a boy. I don't know. Or I may just leave them just like they are and make them 2 little girls. Haven't decided that one yet either. But anyway, that's what I've got going there. Yeah, I think really that's about all I got going. So, that's where I'm at on my amigurumis for this week. I'm not going to make any promises as that if I'll have them all finished by next week. I certainly should be able to have my gnome finished by then, especially if I make up my mind about the hair. The little Geminis, probably one for certain will be finished by next week, but both of them, I don't know. And this panda, I'm just going to say, let's maybe shoot for the front legs, the paws, the toes, the pads, all that. And I'll have them attached for you for next week. Because I'm not, yeah. As Anita said, that's a lot of pieces for those feet. And not that they're hard to do, they're just going to be time consuming. But that's okay. Because when you're making an amigurumi, especially if you're making it for a child or to give away, there's just no rushing things like that, is there? Nope. Okay, well, like I said, that's all I have for you for this week. That's my progress. That's how I'm going. So stay tuned next week. We'll see how much further I can get. Thank you again so much for being here. I appreciate, as always, not only your time, but your comments. And I would like to ask that you just share this out there with some of your friends. You know, maybe they would like to not only see what I'm doing, but also maybe get inspired to get out there and choose a few patterns and get to making some toys. As always, be the light out there in the darkness for someone today, because you never know, could be your light that they need to see. I love you all. Again, thanks for being here. Bye.